band Courage My Love started about 3 years ago. It started with my sister and I, and we've been writing together since the beginning. And it's probably the one that's lasted the longest out of any of the bands that I've been in. In every single band I've been with my sister. And I love writing with her and playing with her and stuff. But yeah, we've been playing shows all over Ontario. We found a manager and a producer, and we're working out of a studio. We record a lot. We play probably around 3 shows a week right now, which is really fun. So yeah, it's hard, you know, anywhere from Sarnia, Mississauga, Toronto, Dunville, Ottawa, you know, all over the place. The type of playing that I'm influenced by changes all the time. I really like hardcore and metal, but, you know, I'm also, I really like blues, you know, Allman Brothers and stuff like that, and indie guitar, fingerstyle. It changes all the time, and it's all easy to relate to each other, so it really depends what I'm listening to. Sometimes it seems like I don't even really hear what's happening. I'm always thinking, oh, what if this was, you know, like a rock cover, or, you know, an acoustic cover, or a piano cover, or something like that. So it just changes all the time. I think some of my favorite influences with bands would probably be the band Oh Sleeper, because I love their guitar lines, and, you know, they just have the coolest guitar tone of all time. And they use Mesa, just like me. I also really like some pop punk bands like Viera. And I like a band out of Guelph that we've played with called Life Story Monologue. I don't know. All over the map. I'm influenced by a lot of stuff for guitar. Guitar players go, I'm a big Slash fan. I mean, who isn't? But whatever. I'm a big Slash fan. And I like a lot of metal guitarists, you know, from a lot of metal bands. But I think probably Slash would be one of my big influences for soloing and stuff. This is my favorite guitar of all time. It is the Ibanez Prestige, and I love it. It's perfect for me. It's got the best pickups ever. They have great definition, you know, when you're doing distorted stuff. And, you know, they're really clean sounding and really powerful sounding. I just like them. They don't really feedback too often, so that's great. It's got a Floyd Rose, and I love Floyd Rose stuff. And I love cutaways because you can just go so much higher. It's ultra thin, which is great for me. Actually, you can see it. I still have this from this bead of tape on it from when I made it into a football for our music video. I just kept it there. And I also have something from our live show. I hold it up and then, you know, it says cheer on it, as you can see. And everyone just kind of in the audience goes crazy when they see that. They think it's the coolest thing ever. Although I didn't invent that, but yes. I sometimes change up the message. One time I put Hi Mom on it because I knew my mom was in the audience. And sometimes I put mosh, stuff like that, whatever I feel like. Yeah, this is my all-time favorite guitar. I don't want any other kind of guitar. So, Ibanez, if you want to endorse me, that would be great, because I love it. I would highly recommend it. We have some new releases coming out soon. We just released a music video a little while ago, and we're releasing another one this summer. We're also releasing a 7-song EP called For Now, which I'm really excited about because we have a great producer producing it, a great studio that we recorded it in, and an awesome artist doing all the artwork and stuff, and I really like the songs. And that's pretty much it right now. And then we're going to go tour with that all summer. We're also releasing an acoustic version of the EP, which will be really cool. It was really fun to record. The acoustic versions sound similar to the electric versions, but they almost sound like completely new songs because we just changed them. And we didn't want it to sound like acoustic versions of band, like full band rock songs, you know, because that would have sounded kind of lame. We wanted them to stand on their own and sound really good, so we switched up a lot of stuff and a lot of arrangements. They're the same songs, but they're just arranged totally differently, so it's definitely gonna be interesting when that comes out. And we have so many new songs already that we're probably just going to release, you know, like 2 more EPs after this one comes out. So, a lot of new stuff coming your way.